You are encouraged to take home a copy of the bulletin or check our website for details about upcoming parish activities. A special welcome to the visitors who are worshiping with us today. Once again this night, welcome Area Right to Life will be sponsoring the 40 Days for Life campaign. This campaign of silent, prayerful, public witness to our belief in the right to life will take place across in the Guelph Community Health Center between February 26th and April 5th. Please see the ad in the bulletin regarding registration for this important event. Please don't forget to fill your bus with any spare change and return to the parish by the end of February. Your spare change donation will help Right to Life reach thousands of people with a much needed pro-life message. 2019 income tax receipts are available to be picked up in the ambulatory behind the high altar after Mass. There are also still some 2020 offertory envelopes to be picked up in the south tower entrance of the Basilica. As we begin Mass, let us all join our voices in singing hymn number 441 in the Catholic worship. You are the way.
Amen.
brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Hear me, dear.
choose, you can keep the commandments, and they will save you. If you trust in God, you too shall live. And to act faithfully is a matter of your own choice. The Lord has placed before you fire and water. Stretch out your hand, or whichever you choose. Before each person are life and death, good and evil. And whichever one chooses, that shall be given. For great is the wisdom of the Lord. He is mighty in power and sees everything. His eyes are on those who fear him, and he knows every human action. He has not commanded anyone to be wicked, and he has not given anyone permission to sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm, number 127, number 127.
Thank you. Organist literacy poll to the curriculums. Brothers and sisters, among the mature, we do speak wisdom, though it is not wisdom of this age, or the rulers of this age, who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which doth God decree before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified as Lord of glory. As it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him. These things God has revealed to us through the Spirit, for the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and the Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. You have heard that it was said to those of ancient times, you shall not murder, and whoever murders shall be liable to judgment. But I say to you, that the one who is angry with their brother or sister will be liable to judgment, and whoever insults the brother or sister will be liable to the council, and whoever says, you fool, will be liable to the devil. So when you are offering your gift at the altar, if you remember there that your brother or sister has something against you, leave your gift before the altar. Go, and first be reconciled to your brother or sister, and then come and offer your gift. Come to terms quickly with your accuser while the two of you are on the way to court. Else your accuser may hand you over to the judge, and the judge to the guard, and you will be thrown into prison. Truly
you, you will never get out until you have paid the last penny. You have heard that it was said, you shall not commit adultery. But I say to you, that everyone who looks at a woman with lust has already committed adultery with her in his heart. If your right eye causes you to sin, tear it out and throw it away. For it is better for you to lose one of your members than for your whole body to be cast into hell. And if your right hand causes you to sin, cut it off and throw it away. For it is better for you to lose one of your members than for your whole body to go to hell. It was also said, whoever divorces his wife, let him give her a certificate of divorce. But I say to you, that anyone who divorces his wife except on grounds of unchastity causes her to commit adultery. And whoever marries a divorced woman commits adultery. Again, you have heard that it was said to those of ancient times, you shall not swear falsely, but carry out the vows that you have made. But I say to you, do not swear at all, either by heaven, for it is the throne of God, or by earth, for it is his footstool, or by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. And do not swear by your head, for you have not the power to make one hair white or black. Let your word be yes if yes, and no if no. Anything more than this comes from the evil one. The Gospel of the Lord. It's not an uncommon thought among Christians, even among Catholics, that the Old Testament really doesn't matter. You know, we don't really have to abide by the Old Testament anymore because, you know, we had Jesus. Jesus did away with it. That the law, the Torah, doesn't really matter for us. We're exempt from all of it because we have Jesus. And Jesus did away with it. I've even had people tell me that we are no longer bound by the Ten Commandments, because the Ten Commandments are part of the old law, and we have Jesus. And Jesus gave us the law of love, and that's all we need. It comes from sort of an idea that we basically, in the simplest form, have it. Jesus good, law bad, says so in the Bible. There's only one big problem with that. It's completely untrue. Nowhere in the Bible does it ever say Jesus good, law bad. That is a misreading of the Gospel and a misreading of St. Paul. Both Jesus and St. Paul will tell us that the law is only capable to do so much. Beyond that, we need the grace that we have in Jesus Christ. Now, to use a modern-day example, an airplane is a good thing. It will take us many, many, many places. But if we want to get to the moon, we're not going to do it with an airplane. Even so, if we want to get to heaven, we are not going to do it simply by the form of the old law. Much of it is still binding upon us. We need the grace that comes to us in Jesus Christ. In the passage of the Gospel that we heard today, which comes from the Sermon on the Mount, Pope Benedict says that this passage is really the Torah of the Messiah. It is Jesus himself handing down the law. But the very first thing that he says in this passage of the Gospel is, do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For until heaven and earth pass away, not one stroke of the letter of the law will pass away until all is accomplished. Now, Jesus doesn't do away with the law. He fulfills it in himself, and then he calls us to an even higher law. There's a part of Pope Benedict's writing in his work, Jesus of Nazareth, where he quotes a rabbi who happens to be a friend of his. And this rabbi wrote a book called A Rabbi at the Sermon on the Mount. And the book sort of pretends to be a rabbi who has been sent to really sort of infiltrate the Sermon on the Mount and then report back to his superiors. And when the rabbi reports back, his superiors say to him, well, did he change the law? Rabbi said, did he abolish the law? Rabbi answers, no, not really. Did he do away with the law? Rabbi said, no, no, he didn't. Superior says, did he add anything to the law? Rabbi says, yes, he did. Say, what? The rabbi responded, himself. Jesus does away with the law, but rather he adds himself as the very focus, the very essence of the law of God. He inserts himself into our history, into our lives, into the law of God, and raises us to an even higher standard. The Lord says to us, I have come that they might have life, and have it abundantly. The Lord gives us what we call a superabundance of grace, and calls us to an even greater life than that to which we are called by the law. Jesus says, in essence, your righteousness must exceed that of the scribes and the Pharisees. Now, all too often we think, well, the scribes and the Pharisees didn't have much righteousness, they're just a bunch of hypocrites. Not true. The scribes and the Pharisees were very righteous people according to the law. It would be pretty hard to exceed it. As a matter of fact, left to our own devices, most of us probably would. But we're not left to our own devices, because when Jesus calls us to his higher righteousness, when he calls us to a higher way of living, when he calls us to a higher law, he inserts himself right into our lives to enable us to live by that higher law. When you talk about Jesus giving us the law of love, it's all too easy for us to simply imagine that he really means that we should just go around having good happy feelings and, you know, sort of don't hurt. We have this tendency to reduce the law of God, and especially this higher law of Jesus, to our own concepts of morality, of love, of righteousness. Instead of doing what Jesus asks and elevating ourselves through the power of his grace to live as he commands. Nay, Jesus is still among us. He still, through his word, calls us to his higher law, and through his sacrament, gives himself to us that we are able to live his command. Yes, we are still bound by the law of God. Yes, we are still bound by the Ten Commandments. But in Jesus Christ, we are called to something even greater. It's not easy. Yeah, there's a reason that Jesus says to us, if you would be my disciple, take up your cross and follow me. The Lord does not call us to an easy life. He calls us to a holy life. He calls us to eternal life. May God bless you.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified on our righteous life. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God has called us to be his holy people through the gospel of Christ. In the power of the Holy Spirit, let us turn to God in fervent prayer. The response to the petition is, hear our prayer. Hear our prayers. We pray that God's goodness will be the source of wisdom for all members of the mystical body of Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that the light of the gospel will dispel the darkness of hatred and injustice and bring comfort to those who suffer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that all of those suffering from civil unrest, especially in Africa, the Middle East, and South America, may be comforted. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that the love of Christ will lead all people to have a greater concern for the good of all people and their inherent dignity, especially the poor, the oppressed, the marginalized, the sick and elderly, and the children of the womb. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray that as we prepare for the holy season of Lent, we may become more truly conformed to the mystical body of Christ through the attention to the word of God and the reception of the Holy Eucharist. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray that all those who are sick or suffering, especially those who are suffering from addictions or mental illness, may know the healing love of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray that all who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, especially Domingo Duarte and Robert Mangalaga, may be welcomed to the glory of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us seek the intercession of the Mother of God and our Heavenly Mother as we pray today. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice is yours, may be acceptable to God and Almighty God.
Thank you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my life, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and prophets, with St. Patrick, St. Bartholomew, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Amen. Oh,